Yo, play something smooth.
Yeah.
Nah, yo, Priest, you don't even know. That's a joke. One time we were on tour, I was like, yo, that rhyme you spit was smooth. He's like, yo, you were the oldest motherfucker in rap. You just said smooth?
Smooth.
He's like, are you fucking like, are you Rakim or Kane? Who the fuck says smooth to describe a verse? I know, I was a little stab at myself. Like, yo, play something smooth.
He's only like, only Greg Nice. Only Greg Nice. Yeah. A lot of the Bay homies use that. But I'm smooth on that. Like, I'm cool.
Yo, so today we have a fucking legendary show. Everybody on the show is ridiculous. On the beats, we have Teddy ROXSPIN. You know, he's the least of the batch, so I named him first. I'm just kidding. I'm just kidding. Shout out to Teddy ROXSPIN, gonna murder the beats. My man Illmac on the fucking rhyme. He's a king of the dot champion, scribble jam champion. I got Killah Priest, legendary Wu-Tang, one of the greatest lyricists in the history. And then I got one of the greatest battle rappers ever, Juice. So this is going to be a special, legendary show.
Hello.
So, welcome to the R.A. The Rugged Man Show, everybody.
Wow.
So listen, that beat's a little too smooth. That looks like the kind of beat you would make, the really clean-cut white guy from Boston type of...
smooth on that.
Give him a little bit of...
Yeah.
Little loft, meanness.
Loft, yeah, you need a beat like you got black neighbors.
Yeah,
like you got black friends.
Nah, you don't mind that I'm making jokes, right?
Nah, Ted ain't
tripping. Sometimes people get sensitive, like, oh, he's a dick, he mistreated me, but
no. You know if I was sensitive, bro.
All right, cool. Oh, there we go. See, I wanted to start the show. Is the beat loud enough? Because I want to start the show off with a bang. Turn the beat up, though. A
little bit.
Turn the beat up. And what we're going to do is...
Yeah, we're going to do it.
Since Juice could battle anybody in history, that's what I'm going to do. I'm going to give him names.
That's horrible. He's gonna
battle motherfuckers.
That's horrible.
If you had to battle Vladimir Putin, do it now.
Listen, Vladimir Putin, you think you run Russia, I'll come out of here shooting. Talking all that bullshit, homie, with a pen and pad. Hit him like Trinidad, but never been to Leningrad. All I'm gonna do is go right to the Russian coast. Show him how it is, he won't dope, well, he could touch a dose. I don't really care about him, cause I destroy a bitch. You know how it is, I'm from Chicago with Blagojevich. But that's just political, you know I straight saw it off. Especially when I miss my old dudes like Gorbachev. So I don't really know about the Russian state. I'm just talking about a dude who can't be touched cause he's great. So Vladimir, listen, one time we need democracy, cause all that bullshit that you doing is just hypocrisy. And I love your bitches, I'ma fuck them like a shopping spree. But if you want the nukes, we got them nukes, you can stop and see.
Hulk Hogan.
Let's go.
Alright.
This all right. All, I didn't tell him none of this shit.
Oh yeah, don't believe that. If you're listening, listen, man, listen. I know about Hulk Hogan. I know the dude was a menace with the 24-inch arms, yellow shirts in Venice, and all of that. I know he was in WrestleMania, but I'm old school like Mesopotamia. Yeah, I'm going back, boy, just to show it off. That's how it is. I'm Johnny Depp, man. I blow it off, so I don't care about him, man. I make the whole brain games change, even though me and him both got the same name. Terry is my name. Terry's his, so we share a name. That's how it is. We both rich. We stare at fames, so don't make me have to be focused like a Nikon. I strike on and kill him for his 24-inch python.
The spirit of Tupac.
Well, the spirit of Tupac, that shit was too hot. But you know how it is, he used to talk a lot. He used to walk a lot, he never played hopscotch but got chalked a lot. Took 5 shots from fucking talking what he believed in. And niggas wanted to make the gods even. I mean the odds even, you saw the gods leaving. There's peas in the pod, you perceive a facade. But anyway, he's in heaven, and now he's dead and gone. It's been a whole long time since the show was on. But I don't really know about it, I'm glad that I caught that. This is a Tupac beat, get it? It's being bought back.
James Bond.
Resurrection. I'll talk James Bond in a minute, but now I'm in a better section. I'm still talking about Tupac Shakur, and I'm sick like your dad, cause I'm no back for more. And I just wanna say that I miss him, I miss Biggie Smalls, but that's how it is. He was always in it all way. Who's the next person you
James
talked
Bond.
About? James Bond, 007, no trouble going to heaven. Always got a gun and always on some spy shit. I act like I'm grounded, but I'm always on some fly shit. I know how it is, man, you know you can't touch me any. Especially when I get that dough, that's that money penny. You know how it is, I shoot when I thrill. I'm cool with the ill, I'm a view to a kill. I'm Roger Moore, I dodge him or Sean Connery. Don't make me fuck around and get ghetto and real honorary. You seeing that shit, I freestyle like a prodigy. I got this old spy shit fucking dripping out of me. Trust me, I get in that ass like sodomy. I know about all of that shit, I give you a lobotomy. When it's time for me to rap, I'm like a soul singer. Next time you see Juice starring in the next Goldfinger.
Nick Cannon.
Nick Cannon.
Battle Nick Cannon.
Battle Nick Cannon. I don't gotta battle Nick Cannon, cause I'm flyer. I split him the same way he did with Mariah. And I ain't talking about then, you know the nigga ain't touching me. I fuck his ex-wife and take the twins with the custody, And now I'm doing them on Thanksgiving. Don't ever battle Juice, how the fuck you rank living? Anyway, Nick Cannon, and you know what my style about. They all on TV, but I'm the one who be wildin' out. You need to have me on a TV show. Even when the river's dry, niggas see me flow. That nigga sick, so cold, he like 3 below. So when you see me on the TV. Oh, I'm talking that dude. I'm just an MCG, so he gon' see me next time he on MTV. Just holler back.
David Duke from the Ku Klux Klan.
I know about David Duke. Don't you fuck around and try to play with Juice. You think I don't know about my motherfucking polarizing figures when it's time for me to scroll rhyme with vigor. I rhyme with vigor like an act legend. Plus, I am a rap legend. When it's time for me to rap, I clap 7. I don't care how it is. I take the skies out. I hate a coward with the white sheets that got the eyes out. I know about the Ku Klux Klan. Fuck, man, I'm real sick. You should see me. I'm like a truck, man. I'm like a truck because I roll like a F-150. When it's time, I murder him and I left one. My race is my race, his race is his race. But that's alright, cause we get money, that's the big face. So I don't care about the fucking Ku Klux Klan. I'm just saying, if he thinks that he's the fucking man, and now he is the softest, now he is the softest. Now he got this dude named Trump for him in office.
Yo, he can keep bars forever, that's so we're gonna let crazy. It rest for a minute.
Bars!
That dude is a fucking scary monster from hell.
Crazy, yo.
That's there's not even crazy. Make some noise for Juice. There's a couple people filming. Yes. Motherfuckers, make some noise.
I'm at a table with a bunch of mutant serpents. That's from other lands.
Yo, pleasure to have you on the show.
Thank you so much.
Thank you for so much for coming through. So how long was your undefeated streak, man? When you was in the battle scene, like back in them days, you had like an undefeated streak.
Yeah, battles used to be different. So battles used to be like 20 people. That Priest know in DC at the Rap Sheet shit. Like it was 20, 30 people in the battle. You had to battle till there was one person. So I mean, if we had to do it match by match, it would be hundreds and hundreds. But because you couldn't just know somebody that you had to battle and write for them. That's a dream of mine. To know who it's gonna be and get months. That's amazing. That's amazing. I'm already on some other. So it's been a long time. Supernatural was my first and pretty much my only loss. I don't know.
I'm like, I remember that. I thought from the jump that you got robbed.
But you can say that. But see, how I looked at it was, okay, so there was an audio feed, and then there was the whole live thing. And so when you weren't there, so you had to listen to it later.
Yeah.
If you listen to the lyrics, okay, fine. Maybe Juice got him. But if you look at the video and the stage presence and the shit he brought to the table, he brought chairs to the table.
Right.
He's not. He brought chairs to the table. Yeah. You know, it wasn't about being a superior MC. He was a superior performer that night, a superior showman. So you know, while I was stoic and when he did a Biggie impression, I should have did the Tupac impression, but I was so solid as an MC, I didn't want to go for the gimmick, and I should have did it. I should have did what I could do. I'm funny. I never showed my personality. He did. Right. So he won that night, but it'll never happen again.
You did the ventriloquist rebuttal or whatever.
He was just crazy because he wanted to pick his beats and shit, and I was like, that's fine. That's why I didn't do it today. But no, I mean, you know, he won that night. But you know, he out there somewhere. He been saying that I'm second, like he's still first. So he know that if he want to come.
But then Craig grabbed him and beat him. So
But I'm just saying, you know, when you say somebody, when you mention specific people and you say that you're ahead of them, you got to prove it. You can't sit on a vacant title. The same boxing don't do that. They strip you of it. So I'm right here, live in the flesh, and I'm in your town now, boy.
Oh, so the rematch right now?
He don't want the rematch. That's what I'm saying. I'm saying it on the air. He knows what it is. I'm saying he's said that he's passed on from that part of his life. Well, then if you've done that, you can't say you number one.
Yes,
that's all I'm saying. Real. If you've passed on, then you just passed on. We'll bury you.
Me and Super Nat had a few words recently because the young boy he was on a Tonight Show freestyle and he was doing freestyle. Okay. So Super Nat called my young boy, Afro is his name, and was like, yo, that's my skit. I made that picking things out the box thing. That ain't cool. You should give me recognition for that. So I called Super Nat and we squashed it, but it was like, he was like really angry, like said the boy was biting his shit, and I said, no, it's freestyling, and Jimmy Fallon was giving him the shit to rap about, and that's part of freestyling, prove that you're freestyling.
Listen, if you only got one routine, you're in trouble. If that pony can't race in the Preakness and the handicap race, if you can't race in the funny car and the stock car and the NASCAR, you in trouble. So if you holding on to that, what do you think people are gonna rap about? It's crowd interaction. Nobody invented crowd interaction.
Yeah.
I don't know that. So that's what I mean, is like, it's sort of like,
if let's say Afro got on the show, right, and he gave Supernatural credit, like, hey, listen, before I do this routine, I want you guys to know, right in Pomona, there's a guy named Supernatural. You can call him at 818-902-7343, and you can actually get the real version of what I'm about to do from him. But Jimmy, throw me some topics. Is he fucking serious? So really, all I'm saying is he's holding on to this aesthetic that he thinks he created. But to me, that shit is simple. Like, the rap you made me do is simple. It's a joke to me where my mind can go. So it's a joke. It's great that you want to talk about pencils, and then it works. And the next thing you know, I see you with your purse. That's cool. But I feel like I drove here with Meek Mill, because it's levels to this shit. So if you're gonna say you the best, you got to be on the other levels. You got to be on them levels, and that's why this cat right here on some real shit, on some writing and freestyle shit. This is why there's other levels to it, because it ain't just about that. No, seriously, no, seriously. Bro. Like, I have it. I know what it is to be a mutant, ninja serpent. So that's all I'm saying.
For the young fans, because a lot of people might not know who Juice is, 15, 14-year-old kids. Who is this guy saying he'll be there?
He's just a guy. Let them
know some of the names on your resume and people you battled in your life.
I mean, it's been a bunch of people. I mean, I don't know. Common. Kanye, because Kanye was heavy in hip hop. It wasn't just about beats.
Right.
Rhyme Fest, Head Crack, Dish Nation, Eminem. I mean, I don't know. It's just been Supernatural.
You beat all of them.
Yeah, except Supernatural, and that's okay. That's okay.
And the rematch should happen right now, right?
I mean, man, the money we've talked, whatever money you want, bro. Whatever money you want to show, because I'll wear a number 2 shirt if I'm second at the battle. So the winner gets the good number 1 shirt.
It's like Joe Louis versus Max Schmeling.
Like, I like what he does and what he brings to the table. I think his advantage over a lot of MCs is his showmanship. Showmanship.
But on the defense of that, though, showmanship, I believe, is a very important part.
Oh,
yeah.
Oh, no,
sure.
That's what I'm saying.
Is
oh, but this but is an advantage. This is why.
A show. It is a
listen,
live show.
Listen, he could end up beating a dude like Rakim, who just stand there looking like God all day. Yeah. I don't know what the fuck I'm supposed to do with you. You got a light shining out of your hair. I don't know what the fuck. I'm gonna have to talk about you. Hopefully, I know why he's great. It's just a difference when he's personally said that he's in my category. I don't agree, and I don't think he could ever prove it.
Yeah. Ooh. So he was pointing at you, Illmaculate. You down to show the people what you got?
Hey, it's whatever. Yeah.
Yeah.
The blaze a little on the. Because I come from that era.
Shout out to Team Backpack. Yeah. Because this was supposed to be Gift of Gab here. And Gift of Gab, you know, is having some treatment going on. So he was like, I called Team Backpack, like, yo, one of my you know, members backed out, and he said, yo, Illmac will come. So I called him up, and here he is. So shout out to Team Backpack. But go ahead, I'm sorry, say what you said.
No, I was just gonna say, like, even on the freestyle tip we're talking about, I'm like, ooh, the blade's a little rusty, but I come from that era, like, you know, did Scribble Jam. I've been, like, the first battle I won was like 15 and 01, where it's like 30 to 64 cats.
That's
in
what
the
I'm
battle.
Talking about, right?
You know what I mean? You didn't know you got to battle, you know, five people, six people in the night, eight people in the night.
The most I ever battled in the night was six people.
Yeah. Yeah.
Mm-hmm. It was in Long Island. See, I'm not known for the battle scene, but that was my childhood. A little kid in that era, you had to rap and battle.
Mm-hmm.
And one time I went to a house party, and I was like about 15, and everybody knew me in the neighborhood. Like, yo, that's that kid. So I went in there, and they all stepped on stage. Bow, one, and I was roasting everybody after the next person after the next.
Did
person.
You have the same name back then?
I was Master Money already.
Juice feeling it.
So then check out this. So the seventh dude gets on the stage and starts roasting me, kinda.
Uh-huh.
These flows, I was like, yo, this dude's more advanced than me. He's getting me. Then I recognized that he was doing Men at Work from G-Rap. I said, that's not even your fucking. He's like, I'm fucking you. I was fucking with you.
I lost a battle like that. Someone was using Big L quotes. Like, you was never shit. Your mother should have swallowed you. I was like, that's Big L. And the crowd, the judge is like, he wins. I'm like, the one line he got off that was the room shaker was an L line. I'm like, this is crazy.
Yo, Priest told me about a dude from in Brooklyn. What was his name?
Oh, Prince Destroyer.
Prince Destroyer. Yeah, yeah, man. Show Prince up people. Destroyer. People sounds... Tell us about that dude.
Yo, he was, yo, he was relentless, man. Yeah, this guy used to walk around neighborhoods, knock on your door if he found out you rap or you knock on your door, tell you to come downstairs, and you had to battle him right there. Yep. He was battling for names back then.
I've been there.
Yep. Yeah, he showed up at Jizza House. Who else house he showed up?
Oh, man.
And the Dishmasters. He showed up at
the Dishmasters and all that. Yeah, man. And when I saw Kane, you know, we from the same neighborhood, but I didn't. He was a little older than me, but I brought up Prince Destroyer. Kane was like, "You know about that?" He said, "Well, ask him what happened when he ran into me." I said,
"Oh wow, man,
that's my favorite of all time."
Yeah. So Kane took out Prince Destroyer,
that's what
huh?
He said,
"Wow,
my favorite of all time." But there's no YouTube videos from the eras, you know.
That's
no
why.
Proof, but
that's
you gotta
legends.
Go by word.
I used.
Know?
I remember, like, I used to before YouTube battles. And that's how, like, I listened to you and Super. Now, when it was like you had to go to MCBattles.com, and like a lot of them were audio, and it was like the old, like, you know, like those battles, like. Yeah. You know what I mean? Idea Blaze battles, and then like you have like PHRIP, you know what I mean? Like,
rest in peace,
like Tone Deaf and Jin Mini Styles and all that. Like I studied that, you know what I mean?
Priest, you said well, back in Brooklyn, The Voice used to conquer sometimes too.
Oh, yeah,
like what
yeah.
you were saying, like the presence. Because he said like Jizza would come with the most complex bars, but sometimes like a loud Brooklyn rapper would come on the scene.
He wasn't loud. It was always the big voice, like Timbo King. Like Mighty Mike Masters, they used to scream on you. Yeah. Scream on you.
Show
as soon as they bring up your mom's. You know, it's like, oh man. About as righteous as my dick.
But screaming at you, right?
Yeah.
And then Jizza come on with the complex rhymes. And yeah, like, yo, the dude screaming about his mom's one.
Right. You gotta do something right now, genius.
Technique versus strength. You know what I mean?
This is deep, y'all.
So yo, let's throw on a beat for my man here.
Here we go.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Is it loud enough?
Nah.
Turn the beat louder. Oh, there you go.
There it is. Got you.
Turn it down, though.
All right.
Lil Mac on the rhyme.
Who's fake and who's real? Lately, who can tell? Get a Roman Catholic open casket. Tell him suit yourself. Leaders never give orders. He wouldn't do himself. Fuck it. Tell him they could get their hands free. I Bluetooth the cell. My bazooka turned beluga whales into tuna melts. Nooses out of Gucci belts and human teeth. Puka shells. Weed charged. Locked up. Now I know how Boosie felt. I'll make a racist pig paint his face in blackface and watch him shoot himself. Yeah, they too nice. That's why I kicked the freestyle legends. J.U. Weiss. The flow is parquet. Catch me with Killah Priest and R.A. at the motherfucking soiree. What you really want? Yeah, I'm still a beast. Killing beast. Got a heavy mental. That's Killah Priest. What you really want, though? It's team backpack. You gonna need a hazmat gas mask. Never rap whack. Used to spray paint with fat caps.
Yeah.
On the freight train. Try to think my brain's sane. But it ain't, man. No, it's off the top. Put them on the chopping block. Make cops chalk the block. I murdered a whole city. Try to kick a flow with me. Yo, no supernatural talent, I'm no biggie. Oh, it's no biggie. You might take 9 shots, but you're no 50. Yeah, I flow swiftly. Matter of fact, I don't care if you roll with G-Unit and you know 50.
I'm like, Fire.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Headphones heating up. Earlobes heating up.
Yeah,
oh.
Check it out, yo. So listen.
What are we talking about?
Now we're going into topical shit.
That's a hard act to follow, though, Jay. Juice's freestyle's a hard act to follow. Yeah, man.
I left a trail of bird seed, and he was right there. I don't want to hear that he couldn't follow that shit.
Yo, so let's talk about topical shit.
Okay. I heard about a lotion that's really good for burns.
His brain's always working into
right.
Topical. Associated.
All right. Yeah. I didn't know what you... I'm sorry. ROXSPIN, I got you, bro.
Amber Rose vagina hair. What'd you all think about that? The big hairy bush, you know. That's her name, Amber Rose, right?
Yeah. Don't you act like you don't know. I don't care if you live in Germany.
She put a poster of her vagina with a big hairy bush.
It's amazing. It's amazing.
For real?
Oh, yeah. My God. You haven't seen it?
I didn't see that. No.
Oh, my.
It wasn't just her vagina to be to paint a clear picture.
No, the vagina was attached. Yeah, it was attached to the rest of her.
I like hairy vaginas. I'm
into anything. It's like a search and rescue mission. It's like reconnaissance for a diver. The shit is... I don't think we understand what we're saying.
When I came up as a kid, when I looked in the magazines, that's what the women had. Vaginas.
Yeah.
And then, you know, when I first started getting pussy, that's what it looked like.
Yeah.
Then all of a sudden, I started keep getting vagina, and they were bald vaginas. I'm like, why are your vaginas bald? Yeah. I thought grown women have hair on their vagina. And now every vagina I've seen, you know, in the last decade or two has a big bald vagina.
It's female pattern balding.
The most disappointing.
It's isolated.
The most disappointing bald vagina I ever had in my life, right? The first time I was with a redhead, she had a big red bush, and it was the most exciting. I kept the lights on. I'm like, I must look at it, you know? It was the most exciting thing of my life. The second redhead I ever fucked, I was like, I pulled the shit down, and there was no pussy here. I'm like, you have no purpose in life except for that red bush.
Why are you here?
What the fuck is it? I wouldn't have took you home. I would have took home the hot blonde or something. You know, the redhead with the freckles, I want the bush.
I'm into all that. French braids down, African beads, whatever you can do to make that shit as long as possible.
Caesar.
You can have it to the sides. It can look like walking in a courtyard building.
I was never attracted to her. Now I'm attracted to her.
I'm into all that. I'm just... You know, as long as you can maintain, you know, like some level of pH balance down there, you can have as much of that shit as you want.
Yeah, okay. Right.
Yeah.
I agree.
Thank you.
Okay, enough topical shit. Let's go back to scene. When, because I'm, you guys are OGs and historians in the battle scene. Me, I'm an old guy. I go, Kumo D versus Busy B. You know, that's the shit I know. Mm-hmm. So let me ask you something. Where did it go from beats to acapella and then back to beats? When did it become an acapella thing?
I don't know, but it's natural evolution.
I mean, like,
I'm not saying it's a bad or good thing. Year did that happen?
I mean, that was like, I remember even when it was still freestyle over beats, like Scribble Jam heyday, you had Smack DVDs, you know, where like the J Mills, Murder Mook, like early 2000s.
So
you know,
it was
like
always might have been 2000.
I mean, they were doing that, and whereas like a lot of it was like mixtape verses, maybe with a freestyle splashed in there at the start or beginning, but it was more about you know, just the bars and less observational and less, you know. So there was that going on counter. I feel like for decades, you know.
So in most of your battles, did you do beats originally or acapellas more?
All beats.
Yeah,
I've never done one that's all acapella. That's why
You don't do the acapella?
No, I do. People just haven't offered the opportunity. To me, it's like I was always over beats, and then I loved deaf poetry, and so when I watched deaf poetry with Def Jam, I was like, wow, this is like, if people was battling with no beats, it's just like crazy. It was a stream of consciousness, and I felt like people's attention spans were shorter, and I felt like in general people didn't want to like. People didn't want the challenge of having to come up with that line to that beat. That beat controls that next line. If you can't come up with that line without that beat, you crazy. But the cats that do it with no beats are so complex in the thoughts. It's so bananas.
Well, I'm sure there's a big payday out there
to me,
for you.
They've offered this thing with somebody that I can't mention, but I'm down, and he say he down, and so, you know, I'm going to have my people. He going to have his people. It's going to be cool. Won't no punches be thrown. Guarantee you that.
That's a little hint.
No, not a hint. Just I know. I don't know the game. I just know that I do this shit as a sport.
And, right.
You know, anything else is uncivilized. So niggas will get uncivilized. But it's a sport. It's a sport.
Do you guys feel like there's an elitism kind of mind state from both sides? Like battle rappers think they're way better than industry rappers, and industry rappers think they're way better than battle rappers. Like, oh, I'm above that battle shit, and battle rappers be like, oh, industry MCs rappers are whack MCs.
I think that it goes both ways, because as much as there that exists too, it's a lot like the underground mainstream beef. Like, that beef is like underground beefing with mainstream. Like, most mainstream artists don't, like, I don't give a fuck about it. Like, I don't do you. But, like, it's like almost like an inferiority complex, I feel like. So it's like the underground, like, oh, mumble rap and all this. I'm like, there's a time and place for everything, you know? I don't want to be
mumble rap.
I'm like, I don't want to be.
There's no time for
I don't want to be like at the popping spot and like, you know, no offense, and hear like Atmosphere, bro. Like, put on some Migos or something. Right. Like, that ain't females. Slug, like, that ain't what. Nah, and it's no disrespect. I came up off that, but I'm just saying there's a time and place for everything. And the same thing with battle rap, but even a lot of mainstream artists, from Drake, hella NBA players, 50, a lot of people come out and be like, the battle rappers are like the spitters out here. You know,
speaking
what I mean?
Of NBA,
like,
players, you saw that Metta World Peace list. He had his top five favorite rappers. It's me, you.
Watches battle rap too.
My man.
Oh, you do? Oh,
yeah. Who's the crazy? Wow. He's talked about it.
Who's my man?
Matta, for real.
The crazy dude who shit on the stage with the tattoos.
Daylight.
Yeah. And Eminem and Cannabis. Those are his top.
Wow.
That's crazy. I didn't know. That's crazy. I need to stay up on my social.
Metta World Peace.
It's funny.
But we both on his top five. So
in Chicago, because he played for the Bulls, and one time he came up to me, he's like, yo, you know what I'm saying? Like, you like Queens? And I'm like, Queens is cool. He's like, so you saying Queens is the best? I'm like, well, nah. No, I don't think Queens is the best. I don't want to get hurt because of it, but I don't think Queens is the best all the time. I mean, they got some people, and then he ended up not hitting me, and we became friends.
I'm not going to lie to you, though. I do think, as an industry artist, when you first, in the 90s, when you first got your deal, you did get an elitism thing where you go, you know, I spent my childhood rapping in them streets, battling. Now I did that to become this.
Right.
Like, that's what you start thinking in your mind.
That's okay.
No. But I'm saying it's ignorance. That's not the truth. And I think this is when I was 19, 20, you know what I'm saying? Yeah. Like, oh, you know, I'm above that now.
Yeah.
You know, and you start going, now I'm making records. But then it's like, yo, we're talking about MCing here. This is who's the dopest MC. And when you're rapping on records talking about I'm the dopest MC, then you're not the dopest MC if you still can't go in the streets. So I think that elitism shit is bullshit. And I also think a lot of battle rappers sometimes, they're pissed at the industry rappers that make a living, and they go, oh, all of them suck. None of them are good. None of them could do what we do.
That's the inferiority complex.
On both sides.
For sure. The deal is this. Listen, like, as hip-hop cats, I've never understood cats that beef with mainstream radio when you're not making that type of music.
Right.
If those two can live juxtaposed from one another, then you go let him do that and you do that.
Yeah.
You don't have to
not
like,
taken away from
No, you don't have to not like Drake. You made 40,000 this year and that's good for you.
Right.
Drake chose to make 200 million. Mm. So it's a whole different thing. Doesn't mean he's better than you. Doesn't mean you're better than him. Just means that unless you're trying to do what Drake does, leave the man alone. Because you'll fuck around and get what Meek got from somebody who got 100 million.
Hey.
Right. And be ruined. So it's all about, it's different. Like, you don't make that kind of music. Those are different genres.
And I think a lot of people's beef, though, is that because, you know, in the 80s, hip hop was kind of underground. And you got gold records like Kane and LL would sell platinum. Yeah. But a lot of the sales, you know, Kool G Rap, you know, would come from the community, you know, But in the 90s, then rap started, like hip hop started crossing over.
Right.
So you had like Nas and Biggie and these guys selling platinum and being the actual biggest stars on the planet.
Mm-hmm.
And I think what some people's beef is that the best rappers aren't, or these great rappers aren't, you know, the ones that even get any shine at all. So I think they get upset about that. Go like, oh, we got to make a record for more of a like Justin Timberlake fans and Katy Perry fans, and we got to intertwine with those people and not the hip hop community. So I understand both sides of the anger there.
Well, can I just add a brief narrative?
Of course.
All right. So to me, there's been a systemic effort to delegitimize urban music. And it's at the top levels of the brass. So when RZA got a deal for $30 million with Wu and RZA, Razor Sharp, and when E-40 got, they was tired of giving cats $30 and $40 million. Hip hop used to have the consciousness you're talking about, but they purposely dumbed it down.
to tell us that this music wasn't selling. And so then when you got in the office to try to get this record deal, they're like, well, you clearly see your numbers are down.
Yeah.
So now that the numbers are down, we're appealing to a less intelligent and less conscious demographic.
Common denominator.
Right,
yeah.
Right, right. So now that they've done that, so now somebody like Drake, who would have been an MC like me and him, looked at what they told him, and he capitalized on the situation. Yeah. Doesn't mean that that's really who he is. Just means that that's what they told him he had to be, because rap wasn't selling.
And
wasn't
Drake spits, too.
Oh, that's
like,
all I'm
crazy.
Saying. We saying the same thing. And you can make Honey Bunches and Tummy Crunches rhyme, then I'm with you.
And he's like, this fool put his money where his mouth is. Literally, like, he funded a King of the Dot event. He's shown up multiple times at the battles, put up a couple hundred K. Don't want to put up, like, just to fund an event, because he studies that.
He's letting you know.
He still has that.
He's
MC,
letting you know that if they allowed him to do it, he'd be where we at.
Exactly.
But they didn't. So I just want people to know that was on purpose. Yeah. That now there ain't no hip hop people getting 3 and 5 million and 4 million.
Well, we got Killah Pre sitting right here. Where I remember on the come up, this dude did 450,000 units. So 450,000, was it the first week or total?
Was that Heavy Mental?
When he had a fucking album release party, this is before I knew him, we went to that block. The whole New York City block was shut down. Cops everywhere.
Nigga,
it was like,
you that dude.
So
that was the time.
So that's the 90s.
But they didn't want that. They didn't want that. They didn't want that. Listen,
did you hear the enlightenment that was on that?
That's all I'm saying.
The knowledge.
That knowledge is going to uplift people, and it's going to change the narrative, and people are going to start being more conscious, and then that's not what they need from certain people.
That's right.
That's why they questioned. I bet you couldn't do that today.
Right.
Of course. Well,
same album drops tonight. What's going to happen?
Yeah.
But that's exactly the truth.
Yeah, horrible. True.
Priest, what do you think? What do you think is the difference from that era when you was in the game with the Rizzes and the Woos, and they were throwing money at you motherfuckers like that, and what happened within the last couple decades where lyricism of intelligence, you get a couple guys could sneak through the cracks, but on the majority, you're not getting no Heavy Mentals today.
Right. I don't know. But back then, it was more about the art. You know, it was about the art, what we was doing, and putting those things together and going to the studios. I don't know. Y'all got it going, man. I'm listening to y'all. Y'all got me going,
yeah, but
man.
You was in this. You was there. You were right there with everybody.
Yeah,
you're like a witness, man.
Yeah.
Okay, if you don't want to talk serious, let's talk about the time when Capadonna did an exorcism on a girl in Brooklyn. Because I know you guys. Because you don't seem to want to be serious, so let's get funny.
What?
Yeah, man.
Yeah, Capadonna used to do exorcisms on girls in Brooklyn. He told me, man.
What
Yo, Cap's my favorite Wu member as a person, man. That's a legend. He showed up at my house the first time I met him, like in 2000. Ooh. And I lived in Harlem across the street from a church there and two churches besides me. And Cap came to my house. Capadonna was like, yo, man, that's why all the Wu-Tang respect you. Like, yo, and you know what? You kind of look like a white Jesus, too. And he's like, and you got the church protecting you on each side.
Oh, God.
He's like, I knew I would like you, rugged man.
Oh, no.
And then he told me about the story. He said, yo, there was a girls in my hood. I had to get, they were possessed. And I showed up at the house, and I had to get the demons out of them. I said,
what?
No doubt, Capadonna, no doubt.
Yeah, Cap is wild. Cap is wild.
You ain't got nothing on the rich.
That's crazy.
Yo, what's up?
Cap is wild.
Come on, tell us some wild out Wu-Tang, man. ODB. Master Killah is the sweetest, nicest dude in history. You said he was a little angry. He was the one that used to punch people in the face,
though. Oh, yeah, definitely.
What?
Master Killah is wild, man. Yo, shout out to Master Killah. Nah.
That's my brother, like, my heart. Yeah. I love him.
I don't know. I think it was, I don't even want to throw his name out there, but
no.
Master Killah is like an expert assassin. That's what I'll call him. Expert assassin. Like, he got mad at this cat. I'm not going to say his name. And Master Killah waited till we took a photo shoot. As soon as they snapped the pictures, punched him in his face. So it's on film. Like, bow, not on picture, punched him in his face.
That's hilarious, because if anybody ever meets Master Killah, it's like the most, like,
humble,
loyal, humble, sweetest, coolest dude you'll ever meet in your life.
Leo, brother.
Apparently not.
And then I hear, like, yo, he was the one that if you fuck with the Wu, man, you know, you got to see Killah, man.
Yeah.
Oh, word?
Yeah.
Not see him, like,
but I'm saying, he was. Yeah, Don't play. Okay.
That's what's up.
Yeah.
That ain't blowing up his shit too much.
Nah, nah.
It's always the quiet ones.
Yeah, yeah. Yeah. It's always the one that doesn't talk the shit.
Yeah, right.
The dude that's always like, I'll knock out everybody in the fucking club is always the one that's unconscious at the end of the party. Somebody knock him out.
In Chicago, Master Killah would be the shooter.
Yeah.
Where we at, he's the shooter. It's always two loud ones and two quiet ones. And they're on both sides of your temples. It's horrible. Watch it.
So what about fights in the battle rap world? Do you see a lot of people punching each other out and fighting? I see like a couple of them on the YouTube.
It's happened, you know, but it's for the most part, like, and people always ask, like, how do you take that? It's like, you know, someone saying such disrespectful things to you, da-da-da. I'm like, and it's like what you said, it's a sport. It's a sport. Yeah, so, like, you see two boxers get in the ring, they beat the hell out of each other and then hug each other after because they know what they're getting into. Yeah. So 99.9% of the time, even if there's animosity, it's a handshake at the end and it's cool. Yeah. But sometimes, you know, you get that energy in the room, and if there's a past or just something's going wrong or someone's losing and all of a sudden like, you know, gets that fight or flight instinct, things happen, you know. You have like a lot of viral battle footage of that, like from Math and then Math again, and then Math and Disaster.
Like ones that people didn't even know, like shit that we might not have seen. Like
I've been in like the closest I've come, I was in a freestyle battle, and in the middle of the round, I was killing this dude. He chokes. He throws the mic down. There's like a shot clock on the side that had it. He didn't drop it. He throws the mic, walks off stage. I pick his mic up and rap like for the rest of his time. And the crowd just goes nuts, right? And then like right before that, right before he choked, some girl in the crowd, like when the DJ was changing the beats, dead silent in the packed house. And this girl's like, "Get that white boy." He goes, he chokes, throws the mic down, leaves. I start rapping and I'm like, "Oh, and that fat chick was probably your bitch, da, 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 da." Everyone's like going off, and I just said that, and then I see him outside. I'm like, "Hey, you know, good shit. It's a battle. It happens, whatever." He was just like, "Nah, fuck that. That's my girl." It actually was, and then she comes bulldozing. There's like a little crowd.
Bulldozing. Hold on.
The bitch bulldozing. Is this a famous story? Because I never heard it.
Nah, but it's like happened to me when it was like, there's no footage of it.
Yeah.
And so like even right before that, she throws her shoe at me, like when I'm in the middle of freestyle, like a platform heel, and it like hits me in my funny bone. I try to act cool, but my arm was kind of dead.
Right in the elbow spot.
So then I see him outside. I think she's just some crazy fan. I'm like, "Hey, it's a battle, you know, good shit, whatever." And then he's like, "That was my girl." And then she comes bulldozing, like trying to swing at me. I like dodge it, and like there's one of the few battles at the time, because this is like early mid-2000s.
This story's taking a while. I bet you got beat up because the story's taking so long. Tell us the story, man.
It's pay off. Like, and then she beat my ass, and that's why I'm here today. No, but it's crazy. But I've seen it happen in freestyle battles, but for the most part, that's like a very small.
You know what's crazy? I hosted the Scribble Jam, or me, Master Ace, and Prince Paul did all like sets, and in the battle, it was the year that the Australian kid won. And
Justice. It was 05.
Yeah, okay.
Year after.
So, and then. It was crazy because the kid Icon said something about copyright getting beat up by
Cage. I was there for that.
And you know what's funny? Copyright called me and said, "Yeah, if you want to sell some merch at my table, fine, because they give you a free table if you're
right."
And then that's the one where copyright got punched out.
He ran up to Icon,
and Icon was notorious for getting beat up by Vinny Paz. And then Icon beat up copyright, so made copyright like that. Don't go down the steps. But
copyright was like trashed at that point too. He like stumbled.
But why did he jump up on him?
Icon was hosting the tryouts, and he said something.
You get beat up by so and so.
Yeah. Sloppy.
That's the thing, man. If you don't like getting embarrassed, you got to stop that. You know, the people who I'm going to battle, I'm like, "Listen, I know you don't like people talking about you, but this is the wrong choice if you don't want to be embarrassed."
Yeah, that's what it is.
I'm all about that. Your whole
sign waivers.
Yeah, your dignity is all that. That's why it's like, it shouldn't even be that you got to have I don't know, I'm gonna make up a gang. You gotta have some, I don't know, some Hermosa Beach Crips or something on the side. You shouldn't even need that at a battle. But now it's the thing where it's like you with your people and you on this, you gotta be. And if anything, see, the Chicago thing is weird because they don't understand the fight part anymore, because that doesn't happen where we're at. I don't, I think people still can. I just think they're shooting. Like, yeah, if I hit you first, you're gonna shoot me anyway. Yeah. So if it's a serious problem, it's a wrap. Don't even, so I couldn't even, I don't even know if I wouldn't even bring. I don't know how to even approach it if somebody was to physically, because they're gonna be embarrassed.
Yeah.
So I don't even. Right. I don't even. Yeah, it's gonna happen. I just don't know what to do. What would you do? Like, what do you do? If because people, you know what I mean. And now you're notorious for like shooting up a battle. Yeah. It shouldn't even be that. I just feel like if it got to get to that point, I'd rather not do it.
Yeah. Exactly. Yo, listen. I want to put Juice on again. He already battled fucking Putin.
Yeah. And murdered him.
Everybody.
Sorry, Hulk Hogan.
Fucking Nick Cannon.
Yeah, you're out of there.
David Duke.
Who's really wilding out?
Now I want to see how he can seduce women.
Black supremacy.
To a beat.
For David Duke.
So I'm going to name some women, and you show how you could pick up this chick in a rhyme. Drop something you like. Is that too slow or is that good? Oh, that's cool, right?
It's cool. I mean, that's a beat, you know.
He don't give a shit.
No, I can't pick it, man.
All right, so Katy Perry.
Well, if I had a chance for Katy Perry, I'd tell her that I get a lot of pussy and you know my lady's very. I tell her when I battle, I retire jerks and tell her that she's a Cali girl and give me them fireworks. Anyway, those are singles that I'm mentioning. And I'm just trying to tell her that, you know, I'm sticking inches in. I tell her that she had a dude with an accent, but I am not British, so come get with this Mr. Black gent and come to the place where we can make it dope, though. And you look crazy, and my dick is a frozen rope, bro.
Ronda Rousey.
Okay, I'm almost done with Katy Perry shit. If you have beef with that dude, you need to bury it. Anyway, I would get Ronda Rousey because she knows she got a good arm bar, but she kinda lousy. And I tell her that my left hook is perfect, my sex look is dope, and my textbook is worth it. So I would tell Ronda that I was like Dana White, and if she wanna fuck around, then maybe we could play tonight. But I am not to be rocked upon. I'm like Baka Brahms, my dick is like eight people, that's why I'm called that octagon. Sup, Rhonda? I got my Honda, and you the bitch that I'm kinda fonda. Plus, you look like Botswana from Oksana, or Oksana, and Blonde Wanda, and Bomb Sandra, and all that. And then we can have a threesome or a foursome. And if you got my homies at the panel, there will be more some. So I'm just trying to get you to retire, cause I'm probably on. My dick hit your ass hard as fucking Holly Holmes.
Sarah Palin. Sarah Palin.
Talk about Sarah Palin. Me and my boys is ill, you know we fucking never paying. I wanna fuck a girl in Alaska, I do though. I wanna go to Anchorage and get a hotel, Juno. I'm just talking about that politics. You never made president, but trust me, you could swallow dick. Plus I got a nice stagness when I blast this. Pussy blind, so I like looking through your eyeglasses. You could fucking know I'm coming late. I could be the president, that pussy be my running mate. I'm talking about Sarah, and yeah, she is an old defeat, but I'm just trying to play handcuffs and let her get a hold of me. Now who's the next bitch, cause I am effortless.
Caitlyn Jenner.
I haven't lost a step when it's time I'm in it. I can't believe you said Caitlyn Jenner. That bitch is a man, she should be dunking on niggas inside the Staples Center. I can't wait to enter, but I ain't finna fuck no man, so tell that hoe I'm late for dinner. I don't care about it, I don't care who the rest you're fucking. I'm just glad, I think you need a breast reduction. That's the reason that you really can't see me wait. Plus I'm fucking crashing like her car did on PCH. You know how it is, you fucking got to see me. Bruce Jenner, Caitlyn Jenner, both be on a box of Wheaties. Fuck it, this is just me and I got the same flow. I know I'm not Skittles, but I'm representing they rainbow. So fuck it, I'm glad she got a sex change. My currency exchange, I'm right when I spit it, it's off my left brain.
Johnny Depp ex-girl Amber Heard.
I know Amber, I know she blonde and cute, right?
Yeah, and he beat
I know how she is, supposedly. He fucking beat her up. But she is like a nifty bitch. I know she like that coke and that alky and that barbiturate. So I would just get you with that. I'm like a pirate ship, especially when she look good and is bushy and that vagina thick. I'm just talking about the way I fucking brandish hoes. If I had Amber, I'd make her fuck with Amber Rose.
Precious.
And that's the double entendre. And that's the kind of shit that y'all fonder. But I'm gonna fuck around, cause juice is finna spit a day. My pockets is big, but not like Gabrielle Sidibe. I know her real name, she precious, and that's an empire. Even though the pussy wet, she'll never take the pimp higher. You know how it is, especially if she nicely dressing. To fuck her, I probably need some past life regression to forget that. Or I would need at least a Malkia and a Kit Kat. I couldn't even try to pop it here. She make me fucked up, she bad. That's why I got some vodka here. You know how it is, she crazy a threat. But if I fuck that big bitch, I'd have to make me forget. So I understand, I put my ears to it. But to fuck her, I need another bottle of this clear fluid.
Melina Trump.
Melania, you Melania. Say her name right. She got a friend named Anya. And she look good, baby doll, and I be on ya. So I know that they both smoke ganja and marijuana. And I got a homie that's named GNL Gonda. And his boys come from Uganda and plus Ghana. So if I had a threesome with them, I get a suite there. And it would look dope, cause I'm trying to have a seat there. When Donald's doing politics, we could all have one. I'm just saying, if you look good, then we can grab one. I know about Melania Trump and she's a citizen. She look like she got a tight. Wonder if I can fit it in. I wonder if I can fit it in. I feel like Barry Bonds, cause I'm just dying to hit again. But they took me out the major league, nigga. I'm like Nas with the freestyle. I play for keeps. Hey, Killah Priest, you know I got that hosted rep. I could be an amputee, but haven't lost a step. Ain't nobody better with my hosted rep. My teeth all dirty, I ain't flossing yet. But that's okay, that's what it cost to vet. I like it when they clapping and they bone out. Take the microphone out. I feel like the strike the way a motherfucker zone out.
Legendary.
Crazy.
I don't think I've ever seen anybody correct a word thrown.
Don't you ever call her the wrong name. Yeah, you got me fucked up. Oh my God, Legendary. Melina.
That was
That was crazy.
Yo, thank you, man.
Thank you,
special.
I'm blessed, man. It's a blessing, man. It's a blessing. This is the wonder of alcohol. I've tried to preach this to everyone who will listen. If every MC who's a little nervous would just relax, we could get these all the time.
Okay, so now here's the thing too. So as an industry artist, I know, you know, I sell the music, I tour, I do stuff. So as a battle MC, what is the way for battle MCs to make a living? How do they go about, you know, paying the bills and stuff like that? Because it's not the iTunes so much. They get paid per battle or something. Or
yeah. Home Depot,
right?
Killing us.
Yeah, Home Depot. he's stupid. I mean, the landscape's changed. It used to be like, you know, one person walks away with some money, but I think when it went a cappella and more prepared, it allowed the fan base to expand, because not everybody just wanted to see people choke all the time and just say observational things. So when people started writing and preparing, it gave a more quality product in the way that not only rappers could appreciate it, because you have a full stream of thought. So the entire fan base like boomed in the, like when it started going written, just so the money started coming in a lot more. Like, and rather than one person getting paid, it's like set up like a fight card. So like you battle one person, you both got guarantees, and there's 99% of the time not a winner decided. It's like the audience chooses, and so it's more so of like you choose who wins the exhibition, like a fight card. And so there's money in that, and the top guys, they can live off that, you know, a few thousand every battle, right? You take 10 battles, you know, you got 30,000-40,000. Yeah, cool. But
it was something weird, the battle I saw, the kid, what was the kid name from Australia,
Justice.
The weird thing is, it was like the winner gets 10 grand, right? And then the two people, the two final dudes at the end said, yo, let's split it no matter who wins.
Yeah.
So the final battle,
I think I've done that
kinda,
a long time ago. Yeah, when it was like that.
The battles before that was harder, but the final one, they kind of both was cushioned because they were both going home with 5 grand.
Was that? It's also the end. You're running out of steam at the end of the night.
Yeah, but don't you want to say I want the 10 grand? Don't you?
But it's like poker players when they get to the final table or it comes heads up. Like I could leave with nothing, and you could leave with nothing, and there's a mutual respect in the way of like I could leave with nothing or I could leave with 5K rather than 10.
I'd rather get that guarantee because we're here. So I think I've done that like a long time ago with a homie. Like it came down to me and the homie.
You did it too?
No, it's like me and a homie came down. We drove together and came down to us in the finals.
Oh, it was your boy.
And I'm like, we're going to split it. He's like, yeah, I'm with it. I'm like, cool. You know, but.
Let me ask you something. Do you find more today that like, because they have time to prepare who their enemy is and all of the shit, that people have like their boys helping them with bars ahead of time and like their boys are writing punch
lines? It happens, you know, like
you
there's
would?
Been there's been battle rap scandals like that, like people who have like shown PayPal receipts and like in the middle of battles
wrote,
like you paid me for this shit, you know what I mean, or you paid so and so for these bars
to write the line for
you? Yeah, and that's gonna the thing about battle rap is everything comes to light, you no matter who you're dealing with. So I wouldn't recommend that, you know. And there's a difference when you're preparing with your homies and you throw out something. Like I've done it, like thrown out, like I got this skin, like, oh, you should say that, like this one extra rhyme would be like, oh yeah, you know, right. As opposed to having someone write for you, you know what I mean? But that happens, you know what I mean? Like people
much
get written for.
Battle scene today is like what Juice does, where like you did your battles freestyle all the time. Every
if it was, it was always required. They never let it, because everyone was like,
because now they're written.
That's what
mostly,
I can't,
right?
Yeah, you can write now.
How many people freestyle off the head during battles do you think?
A lot, right?
A fair amount. To me, because I like, again, I come from that, like, my favorites are the people that do that, because they can make magic on the spot. So no matter what you get hit with by an opponent, it could be the biggest room shaker, mm-hmm. and then all of a sudden you just flip that on them. You not only zeroed out their hardest hitting line, mm-hmm. but you gave yourself an advantage off the first line because you just X'd out. There's just like Hollow, Disaster, Thesaurus, like, and there's others. But
you,
these are the cats
Iron.
That are all yeah me. Iron. There's these are the cats that will incorporate. Freestyle, get back to their script. Maybe if something's happening during the middle, be able to leave the written, address something that's happening, hop right back in. And the best people and the most entertaining to watch are the people that do that.
It's a gift.
And incorporate both worlds.
You know, it's funny. You know, I'm so old school. You guys are like Hollow, all of this stuff. I'm like, well, in my day, Roxanne Shanté did all freestyles. Because it was true. Supposedly, if you battled Roxanne Shanté, she'll go 6-7 minute freestyle.
Right.
Half of her records. Like, a lot of her records were written by other artists because her big songs, like Have a Nice Day, she just went off the top of the head.
Right.
So when they were like, oh, we got to go to the studio with a written, somebody would write the rhyme, but most of the time she'd freestyle all her best rhymes.
What?
Yeah. Yeah.
See, I feel like Migos does the same thing. Like, I see, you know, so not, like,
don't,
I see.
Don't mark me 100% on that,
yeah, but I'm just saying, what you're saying is she's an MC.
Yeah.
I need to respect her when
I. He said Migos.
Nah, like, I seen him literally do the, was it the Llama book? Like, Mama, Llama, whatever. Yeah. Like, as a song, they put on a trap beat and they're reading the pages and it sounded like one of their songs and they're like doing it like freestyle. And like, you got homies like ad libbing, like, Llama. And that's crazy. Like, yo, they can literally freestyle a hit. You
nothing
know?
To do with battle, right? Well, it does have a little bit to do with battle because Roxanne and UTFO, but rest in peace to the educated rapper who passed away. One of the innovators of flows that.
Your name was Harry?
Everybody did that shit.
Amber Harris Harry?
Yeah, Amber Harris Harry.
Brooklyn too, man.
Yeah, rest in peace, you know, Brooklyn icon. And also TC Islam. TZ Islam was murdered in Atlanta, Zulu Nation, TZ Islam, and he was murdered, so rest in peace to him. And let's go back to, I already know your answer, you're going back, nobody. But is there any MC roundtable discussion that when they spit, you hear them and they kind of scare you a little?
Oh, there's a lot.
Yeah.
Who's an MC today that you're like, God damn, that fucker scares me?
There's a kid from Detroit named Elzai, and every time
Elzai scares
every time he rap, I'd be like, he got one, he said, I'm AWOL, you may fall, my Wakita is a spray y'all and put you in a hole like Robin Peter to pay Paul.
Ooh.
I'm like, all right, well, glad we're friends.
right?
Glad we're friends. Whatever restaurant he's at, it's on me. I'll call ahead.
What, is there an MC that scares you?
I like Elzai too.
Remember that Demon song you showed me from Elzai?
Man.
Yeah, I can just each line with the demons.
Nice.
This is what I ask every
episode.
Done
talking.
First rap album you ever remember listening to?
Oh, I don't know.
It was a mixtape. It was called Jammin'. I feel like it was a soundtrack. And I was like four or something. My grandma gave it to me. And it was like, had all the old school.
Wait, how old,
like,
can you talk too fast? How old were you?
I was like four. Nah, yeah, yeah. My grandma got like a cassette thing at a yard sale, and she's like, "Here's a hip hop tape," and I'd like use her Walkman to listen to it. And it had like Run DMC, You Talk Too Much, Curtis Blow. It had like all Sugar Hill Gang, like all the old school. And I used to just bump it nonstop.
Yeah. Yeah. Might have been KRS-One's first joint for me because
a criminal minded.
Criminal. I remember being because I was born in Chicago. I moved out here when I was 4. Yeah. K-Day was trying to like play all of the hip hop from East and West, and I gravitated. I matriculated toward the East Coast. It was more complex for me. Mm-hmm. It was more represented where I was at. I wasn't killing anyone. Mm-hmm. I didn't understand the whole dynamic. I was in the hood, but I didn't get it. And so I remember hearing that record and going, "Oh my God!"
Classic, yeah.
I don't even know what to really say. Yeah. His last name was Parker, like mine. I was like, maybe we're kindred spirits or something. Wow. But I just knew that and Big Daddy Kane's first album made me want to go stupid.
You want to spit one more and to show off with another little something?
Yeah, we could do that.
Is that cool?
Yeah.
All right, give him something vicious.
Yeah. Something vicious, look.
Top ramen dry, that's commissary, fell in charge. Sipping mama's Kool-Aid out of Tom and Jerry jelly jars. I remember playing pogs, a bully tried to jack me, choked him, swung until my hands were broken, before I got a slammer stolen. I remember rice and spam, I ain't talking bad promotion. Dropped out of high school, don't put me in the class with no one. Used to not having shit, only thing I lack's emotion. Fuck the world, pack a Trojan, hustle till my casket's open. Daddy's home, back will roll up, yeah, blowing like a saxophone. I'm Leonardo, wait, Da Vinci or DiCaprio? Catch me if you can, Vitruvian man. My pad is sculpted of granite stone. I ain't come from a happy home that was broken. Dad would throw whatever in the macaroni casserole. Couldn't cop chicken from Alberta Street Market. I take you to Pier Park where the murder streak started. Now it's tours, comma luncheons. More honest hustling, more commas coming. Shit, form follows function. You couldn't have taught us better, cause what we capture writing is next to godliness. Omnipresent, absent minded. I write it like my hand was guided. I had to make a path to find it. I never fronted, so I stand behind it. This is P-Lo's on deck. The beat load, I'm Debo on set. Cerebro complex, as far as equals, I don't see no prospects. My deep flow, decode the genome project. Head empty, you could probably see those cobwebs. And weed smoke, I think slow, reload, process. I can't remember last when my ego got checked. Juice probably listening like we know, God bless. And these the thoughts I conjure. I killed the job of my monster with a rocket launcher, and then told Luke I'm not his father. Profit margins on my thoughts, get my pockets larger. Chronic spark clock the carb, now I'm coughing carbon. Tell the police that they searching in the wrong apartment. Knew there'd be a rat in the end, cause I watched Departed. They fly as Peter Pan, I ride Peter to pay Paul, and I need a grand. So better re-examine and let me see those hands, cause I don't need no brand. This is kilograms in a speedboat in the Rio Grande.
Yo, Illmac, I'm glad I made you spit again, because your first rhyme was dope. That one was doper, even.
Yeah.
Man. Yeah, yeah.
My fucking warm up, boy.
Yeah, had to transition. Warm up. Was like, warm up. Shaky in the beginning.
Yeah, I was like, he walked in. I never seen him in person. I said, "Are you a white guy like me? Or are you black? Or are you Mexican? Or what the fuck are you?" I couldn't figure it out. He was like that. You know, it's the white guys that you don't know what the fuck they are? They look like. Like some Martian shit, or you don't even know what the fuck. And but he said you're half Spanish or Mexican, right?
Yeah, Mexican native.
Yeah. And then, you know, the white supremacist is devil. Like, damn, I thought he was like us. I'm not going to listen to him.
I'm half devil. I'm half white.
I was going to put Illmac, Slane, Vinny Paz, and R.A., but fuck, he got Mexican in him. Just the white boys.
Overrated.
You know, there's those white supremacist rappers be like, I like Vinny Paz, R.A., Apathy. They don't even name one black rapper ever.
Yeah. People hit me
sometimes. They sneak a Mortal Technique in there, like, right. Okay.
Right. People hit me on Twitter, like, my top 5 battle rappers, and it's like,
all white
Sharone, and like all these white, and I'm like, Team White, huh?
Yeah.
I'm like,
that's what you're going with. Like, I don't want to be on your fucking top 10 rappers of white skin list, motherfucker.
Yeah. That's crazy.
It's crazy, yo. Like, what the fuck?
Where am I at? I had stuff to do today. I swear I did.
I think we're done. Hey, make some noise for Teddy Rockspin on the beats. Yo, Killer Priest is the silliest motherfucker. He's got jokes. I thought he was going to be like the Ed McMahon, Johnny Carson thing. And I pass over, like, make a joke. And he'd be like, yo, they're too serious, man.
He's like, ribbons.
Like, nah, you don't understand. If you go on, if you go on tour with Priest, it's like joke after joke after joke, and it's like how you say that word? Philosophical.
Philosophical.
I used to have a lisp really bad. It took me years to get away from it, you know?
Yeah.
And in fact, if you listen to my really, really early recordings, you could hear the shit, and people be like, why was you used to faking a lisp? And I'm like, I used to be in speech class. They'd be like, yo, put your tongue behind your teeth, like, and I'd be... Yo, I think today's show was legendary. And yo, yeah. Illmaculate, thank you so much for coming.
Thank you,
Juice. Thank you so much, man, for coming, man.
Anytime.
You guys are fucking everybody here. The legendary show, one of the best shows I ever did. Killah Priest, one of my best friends in the world, man, and one of the greatest lyricists in the history of rap.
Thank you.
And ROXSPIN on the beats. Already rugged man show.
Hey, Poetry, you a legend. I want to tell Poetry, you a legend. I already know. Body and Soul days, we just going back, way back. I just, legendary.
Our girl Poetess, we're at her podcast spot, and legendary. She's a legend. She used to do records with G-Rap back in the day. Yeah. She's just a California legend.
Period. And sorry about that.
Last time I came in here, I didn't know who it was. I fucked up, and then I figured it out, and I'm like, I'm a fucking idiot, man. I pride myself on knowing that stuff, so shout out to Poetess. And what's the name of the place? Should I advertise it? MorrisMediaLine.com. If you ever want to rent out studio time to do a podcast, call Poetess's spot, MorrisMediaLine.com, and do it here. The ultra professionals, and Joke on the camera. He just shot a video for Gift of Gab and Afro and Me. He's a great video director. And he's an artist, too. So, and wifey. He's got his wifey Nova with him. Beautiful.
Quick
love story. Joker met his wife. He casted her as like one of the girls in a music video, and then they've been together ever since. So
I have to play my wife.
He got to play the wife in the video, then he married
her. Got her used to the role.
Right. Got her used to the role.
Desensitized.
She was the top pick. She wasn't the video girl.
Thank you, legends. Thank you, all you legends, for coming and rocking with the R-Rated Rugged Man show. I love you all. You guys are great. Thank you.
Thanks.
That was crazy.
I took you too.
The show.
Absolutely.